God, Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Oh, I want my heart to be ready, Lord. I want my mind right now to be girded up. I want to be ready to take action here today. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I want to bring your attention to the book of Luke and the account here of Jesus' triumphal entry here in verse 35. I don't know if you can see the screens to read with me. Would you read what you can see? And they brought him to Jesus, and they cast their garments upon the colt, and they set Jesus thereon. And as he went, they spread their clothes in the way. And when he was come nigh, even now at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice and praise God with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen, saying, "Blessed be the King that cometh in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest." I wonder today, as we remember that Palm Sunday, if we would begin to shout with a loud voice and praise, just like the disciples, just like the multitudes began as he began that triumphal entry. Oh, Lord, we praise you. We glorify you. We magnify your greatness. God, I want the whole world to know all your glorious works that you're doing. We praise you for it. God, the soul that you're going to save today, we glorify you. We praise you for it. We give you all the honor.
Praise the name of the Lord. Oh, let's put our hands together this morning.
Thank you.
today through that eastern gate, that golden gate. The Bible says in Mark that they shouted, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in Hebrew means, we pray, save us, or pray, save us. That's what the people were crying. When we sing hallelujah, that means that we give ourselves. The highest praise is that we give ourselves back to Him. See, He was walking into that gate and they were saying, save us. And just 7 days later, He would. We'd find out the death, burial, and resurrection happened on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, figuratively. But on Palm Sunday, it's like, save us. I'm glad I have a God that I can cry to that says, save me. Whether it's my soul or from myself or from a situation that I'm in. Hosanna to God in the highest. He's a great God, and no rock's gonna cry out for me. Oh, you've been so good. You've been so good. I thank you, Lord. I thank you. My heart is full. My heart is full. I love you, Lord. I love you. You've been so good. I thank you, Lord. My heart is full. Hosanna, we have a Savior today. You've been so good. shout hallelujah. Somebody shout Hosanna. Somebody shout thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. No rock's gonna cry out for me on Palm Sunday. No rock's gonna cry out for me. Hallelujah. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. I'm breathing, I will always. nobody can do it for you this morning. I wonder, church, if you would just get lost in praise for the next several seconds and minutes. I wonder if you could close your eyes and raise a hand, not look what's going on up here, but look to heaven this morning. Hallelujah.
Come on, one more time. I think we can do better than that. Why don't we give some willful praise? Not because if anybody asked you to do it this morning, but because He is good. Why? Because you are God and God alone. God, I thank you for all that you've done for us today. God, you're so worthy, Jesus. Come on, would you? Why don't you scoop up some praises unto heaven this morning? Because I'm thankful, but I can't help but think that if you will reach out to Him this morning, I feel like God wants to do something special in somebody's life this morning. I feel like God wants to do the miraculous, fill someone with the Holy Ghost, let someone come to repentance. I feel like God's got something special for someone this morning, and I'm thankful for that this morning. God bless you one more time. Would you give the Lord a great hand clap of praise as you return to your seats? Talking about some great things that God is doing at Apostolic Center. This certifies that Carol Wilkins received the Holy Ghost on March 10th at Apostolic Center. Would you come down? We got a certificate for you. This certifies that Stephen Edwards was baptized in Jesus' name on March 17th. Come on, let's give the Lord a great hand clap of praise for what He's doing. I believe He's not done yet. If you've never received the Holy Ghost with evidence of speaking in other tongues, if you've never repented of your sins, been baptized in Jesus' name, you can receive it this morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God. You may be seated. I want to take care of a few announcements this morning. Tonight we have a baby shower for Dawson Nichols, and that will be after service in the coffee shop. Then April 7th, 14th, and 28th. You can join us again for 1-2-3 Magic. It's encouraging good behavior. It's at 8:30 in the conference room for the second series. There's room for a few more parents. If you are interested, please see Sister Lorena Pope. March 31st, Easter Sunday, we have our Easter egg hunt and our Mac Easter. Immediately following Easter service on the back lawn at 11:30, we will start our Easter egg hunt. And in between time, up until that, we will have a photo booth and the Easter bunny outside where you can take pictures. There'll be games and activities and all kinds of other things that we have planned outside for our kids as you wait for the big Easter egg hunt. Some baskets are available, but if you can bring your own, that would be helpful. And then if you are interested in being part of Apostolic Center Media Team, please fill out the form on the QR code. There's many other announcements and information on the QR codes if you want to scan those to find those details. Upcoming dates and events. Sunday, March 31st is Easter Sunday, and the theme is Today is the Day of Salvation. And of course, we celebrate the Good Friday, and we celebrate that into Sunday. But wouldn't it be awesome? Wouldn't it be awesome to see some guests and backsliders and people come into the house of the Lord, be filled with the Holy Ghost, be refilled. There's so much going on at Apostolic Center, and what a great fulfillment it would be to see someone come and see someone's life be changed on Easter Sunday. It's a great time to invite your family, invite your friends, coworkers, whoever it may be, whoever God lays on your heart, invite them to the house of the God. We know, obviously, we can feel it here this morning. We know that they will feel the presence of God. And reminder that today is the day of salvation, Easter Sunday. Sunday, April 7th, is our baby dedication. On that dedication, you can sign up at the welcome station. At this time, I wonder if you would all stand together. The past few Sundays, we've been doing a little meet and greet. We want you to get out from your seats, get out from your aisles. If you're in the risers, why don't you make your way down? If you're on the floor, make your way up. We want you to greet one another. We are a family-friendly church. Why don't you greet someone, introduce yourself, tell them how glad you are to see them in the house of the Lord this Sunday morning.
Thank you. Your blood is a rescue to the sin-stained life. Your blood is a healing to the hopeless and broken. Your blood is enough. Jesus, it's enough. Your blood is a shelter in the middle of my storm. Your blood is my refuge when I'm hurting and alone. Your blood is enough. Jesus, it's enough. It's renewed, restored, saved. The sin-stained life. Your blood is healing to the hopeless and broken. Your blood is enough. Jesus, it's enough. Your blood is a shelter in the middle of my storm. Your blood is my refuge when I'm hurting and alone. Your blood is enough. Jesus, it's enough. Oh, it's renewed, restored, saving and healing, delivering. The sin-stained life. Your blood is healing to the hopeless and broken. Your blood is enough. Jesus, it's enough. Your blood is a shelter in the middle of my storm. Your blood is my refuge when I'm hurting and alone. Your blood is enough. Jesus, it's enough. Oh. Oh! you, Lord, for your blood. It's more than enough for me. Lord, when I needed forgiveness from my sins, it's more than enough. My past washed away, Lord, it's more than enough.
Today is. Aren't you thankful for the Lord? I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful. I'm so thankful. We are getting ready for our Easter service. I encourage you to bring someone to the house of the Lord. And we're going to have great church today. Next week, and the week after that, and the week after that. But praise God. Thankful we know how to have good church. But we need to bring people to the house of the Lord so that they can be encouraged in what the Lord is doing. Praise God. I'd like to take your attention to the book of Matthew, the 21st chapter. There is a traditional viewpoint of this Sunday. Many call it Palm Sunday. I'm going to read to you what many would speak and call, speak to and call the triumphal entry into Jerusalem, and coming from the Jericho Road, which stretches over Bethany to the Mount of Olives and then to the Eastern Gate. And but I want to share a few things with you this morning, if we can. I'm never much interested in just casual church. Casual church is nice. It's very easy to fit in. But when Jesus comes, usually something happened. You've heard me say many times, the lukewarm church neither offends or affects anyone. I'm not trying to be offensive, but this morning, hopefully, in this service, you're going to be affected in some way that helps you to serve God. The book of Matthew, the 21st chapter, and when they drew nigh unto Jerusalem, they were come to Bethpage, unto the Mount of Olives. Then sent Jesus two disciples, saying, go into the village over against you straightway, and you shall find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Loose them and bring them unto me. And if any man ought unto you, ye shall say, the Lord hath need of them, and straightway he will send them. And all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which is spoken by the prophet, saying, tell you the daughter of Zion, behold, the king cometh unto thee, meek and sitting upon a donkey, and the colt of the foal of a donkey. And the disciples went and did as Jesus commanded them, and brought the donkey, and the colt was put upon, their coats were put upon, on the colt their clothes, and they set him there on, and a very great multitude spread their garments in the way. Others cut down branches from trees and strewed them on the way. And the multitudes that went before him and that followed cried, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. And when he was coming to Jerusalem, all the city was moved, saying, who is this? And the multitude said, this is Jesus, the prophet of Nazareth of Galilee. And Jesus went into the temple and cast out all them that sold and bought in the temple, and overthrew the tables of the money changers and the seats of them that sold doves. And Jesus said unto them, it is written, my house shall be called the house of prayer, but ye have made it a den of thieves. And the blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he healed them. And when the chief priests and scribes saw the wonderful things that he did, and the children crying in the temple and saying, Hosanna to the Son of David, they were sore displeased. And he said unto them, hearest thou what these say? And Jesus saith unto them, yea, have you never read, out of the mouths of babes and sucklings thou hast perfected praise. Perfected praise. I want to preach to us just for a few moments. Praise will start you there, and praise will keep you there. Praise is the bookend to everything that happens in our world when it comes to serving Jesus. Your praise is important. Nobody can do it for you. Nobody can do it for you. Look at somebody and tell them, my praise is important. Lord Jesus, we love you. I thank you for what we feel. Help us this morning. Lord, we're asking you to minister to every heart and every life. Strengthen us, keep us, protect us, I pray,
in the name of Jesus. And everyone said amen. Amen. Turn around, look at somebody, turn to the person next to you and say, you look like you've already come dressed for Easter. Chapters 1 through 20 of the book of Matthew begin to tell us the story of who Jesus is. He is Emmanuel, God with us. He was the babe that was born in a manger at Bethlehem. He was the one that grew up in Joseph's and Mary's house, the son of a carpenter. But yet he was also the one that was baptized of John the Baptist. And yet it's John the Baptist that looked at him and said, I need to be baptized of thee. That Holy Ghost and fire that I was talking about and preaching about. That's what I want to receive. It is Jesus that calms storms, and it's Jesus that turns water into wine. It's Jesus that casts out devils. It's Jesus that heals tormented sons. I'm talking about the Jesus. That could stand at the bow of the boat and say, peace, be still. I'm talking about a Jesus that could show up at a tomb and a man already stunk in his burial garments, and he could say, Lazarus, come forth. It's Jesus who could just be walking by and a woman with an issue of blood could reach out and touch the hem of his garments and be made whole. And I've got good news for you. The same Jesus that did those things in chapters 1 through 20 is the same Jesus that permeates this place this morning. There is healing in the house. Physical healing, emotional healing. There is strength in this place because we know the name of Jesus. Praise God. I'm glad it's not just, the Bible is not just a history book, but the scripture tells us that the word of God is quick. In other words, it's alive and powerful and sharp, and it pierces and it deals with and it strengthens. This word that we're reading today is not just printed pages, but he's here, ready to do his work. Jesus is now in the last week of his life, and he is coming on the Jericho Road. Isn't it amazing that Jesus starts at the beginning of the conquest, the road of the conquest, Jericho, and yet makes his way to Jerusalem? This is the crowning moment. And Jesus tells two of his disciples to go over to the village next to you and find a donkey with her colt. Jewish writings will tell us that you could not separate a mother from the colt. And yet Jesus is riding on a donkey. He's riding on a donkey, sitting on a donkey, mounted on a donkey. This king is prophesied about. I'm glad I know that Jesus is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. But this was done so that they could tell, behold, thy king is coming to you. I think we miss that sometimes. I'm just wondering, is Jesus the king of your life? Hallelujah. He's coming to you meek or gentle and sitting and mounted on a donkey. Notice This was a donkey that had never been ridden before. This wouldn't be something that would be easy or that the donkey would be accustomed to. It'd be like getting on a wild horse. Sitting on something that wasn't gentle and meek. Mark 11 tells us it had never been ridden. But Zechariah prophesies that the king is coming riding on a donkey. This is not like David, who is a king of war. This king, when we talk about Jesus at this point in time, will ride like a Solomon with peace and gentleness and meekness. What are you saying to us this morning? Just stay with me. I realize the time, but I've got plenty of time to say what I need to say. He's coming in like a Solomon. He's coming in with peace. Now, when he comes the second time, we're not talking about the rapture of the church, but for the Jews, he's coming a second time. His feet are going to stand on the Mount of Olives. It's going to part. He's going to walk through the eastern gates, and it is not going to be a time of peace. He's going to destroy the armies of the Antichrist and Armageddon. You're going to have to make sure which side that you're on. But Jesus enters Jerusalem this time, 2,000 years ago, meek, mild, and gentle. Just like he's in this place this morning. He's a gentleman. He's gentle. He's peaceful, full of meekness, giving us opportunity to find peace and to find a place in him, riding on a donkey. Notice how he's coming. He's coming in. They're getting ready to celebrate three feasts: Passover, unleavened bread, and first fruits. Praise God. What is Passover, unleavened bread, and first fruits? What does it signify to us today? It signifies death, burial, and resurrection. It represents repentance. The Passover lamb had to die. Without the shedding of blood, there's no remission of sins. He had to be the Passover lamb. Unleavened bread, what does that have to do with? Unleavened bread, amen, had no corruption in it, had no toxins, no poisons. The scripture tells us that while he was in the tomb, that his body saw no corruption. That's why you can be water baptized in Jesus' name and be born of the water. The Lord takes out all the corruption, all the sinful nature. Come on, I wish I had somebody help me this morning. Hallelujah. All of these feasts would be in succession. And then what's first fruits? The first fruits of the resurrection. A type and shadow of the Holy Ghost. That same spirit which raised Christ from the dead must dwell in you. I mean, all this stuff, it isn't coincidence. It isn't just happenstance. Jesus was setting a pattern for his church. That's why if you've never repented, or it's been a while since you've repented, you need to find a place of repentance. I don't want to be like Esau. The scripture said he found no place of repentance, though he sought for it carefully with tears. I want to be able to easily move into the presence of God and say, God, I know I'm not what I should be, but you love me enough to die for me. Hallelujah. Baptism isn't about getting wet. It's about taking a bath. It's for the washing and the remission of sins. Taking on his name in baptism. And so Jesus is coming to do his redemptive work for the church. And so how is he received? Let me tell you how he's received. The scripture says that the multitudes went before. You can be seated. The multitudes went before that followed and cried, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. What is this word, Hosanna? It means save us, deliver us. It's about adoration. It's about praise, understanding that he's the only one that can deliver. He's the only one that can set free. He is the only one that can save. And somebody said, before you do it, I'm going to get a praise going in my heart that I understand you are God and you are God alone. You are the king that saves and delivers. No wonder Joel, writing in the Old Testament, said, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be delivered. Hallelujah. There's something about praise that puts us in a place where deliverance can happen. Hallelujah. I know we're worshiping a lot of things these days. Hallelujah. But my worship is reserved for him. I'm more interested in him than the NCAA tournament going on right now. I'm more interested in him than what movie's coming out next week. I'm more interested in him. Say, well, me too. Then you know what? I ought to praise him because I want his attention. He inhabits the praises. You want God to show up? Start praising. Hosanna in the highest. Let me tell you what praise does. Hallelujah. And I could talk about, I'm not going to take time this morning to talk about the seven postures of praise, but maybe it's time that we begin to understand, why do we clap our hands? Why do we lift our hands? Why do we lift our voice? These are not things that are uncommon in Scripture. Why do we dance before the Lord? Why do we leap or jump before him? These are not abstract concepts from Scripture. This is exactly the model for what he wants. That's why he called you out of darkness into his marvelous light, so that you could show forth the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Why would anybody want something that someone else is not thankful for? Hallelujah. Let me, we go eat somewhere and it's bad. We tell everybody, mm-mm. What do you think about such and such? Mm-mm. No, 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 no. I feel a will of spirit upon me. No, 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 no. No. But if it's good, man, why do you think I look the way I look? That stuff is good stuff. We'll heap all kinds of praise on it. Man, even the tea's good. Even the coconut juice is good. It'd have to be really good for me, like coconut juice. They've been eating coconut cake. Shame on them. Praise God. But man, we'll brag on that. We'll brag on all kinds of stuff. And when you brag on something, when you praise something, it piques people's interest. That's why when they were praising, here's the question. Who is this? I'm going to try that again. They were crying Hosanna in the highest. They were praising until someone and many began to ask, who is this? Hallelujah. A crowd loves a crowd. I remember my dad used to say, we were getting ready to build the church and even talking about there on 9th Street, there's a possibility we were going to build there. He said, he'd always say, well, your parking's got to be in front because a crowd draws a crowd. Hallelujah. No, hey, if you pull into a restaurant and there's two cars there, there's something in your spirit makes you go, But there's a line out the door. Guess what? It probably good or really cheap. Hallelujah. I just tell you right all now, avoid the buffets. Especially this COVID. Just lick your finger. Every person's, okay, anyways, where'd I go with that? Crowd draws a crowd. You know why? Because somebody's saying, this place is good enough to get up off my lazy boy, get in my car, drive there, wait. Oh, and we come to church and, my God, it's 10:51. Good Lord, I hope we get out of here. Me too. Crowd draws a crowd. Everybody's curious. Because everybody's saying, man, something going on. There's people that's jumping and praising. They don't even know who it is because it's so contagious. I pray our churches that way. When people walk in the door, I don't know what I feel, but everybody here seems happy. Everybody here feels like it's good. I need to know who this Jesus is. Come on, I know who my doctor is. I know who my psychologist is. Come on, I know who my teacher is. But I want to introduce you to someone greater. Come on, clap your hands, all you people. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. That's scripture. Come on, just like they did. When he was coming into Jerusalem, they gave him a wave offering. Till everybody said, who is this? We quit praising, people are going to quit asking. That's why I come to church excited about church. I can't wait to see what God's going to do. Say, well, you're the preacher, you got to show up. No, I don't. It's probably good for employment, but I don't have to show up. I make all kinds of reasons and excuses why I don't come. But there's an anticipation. There's something about where two or three are gathered. There's something about coming together and corporately saying, I want to feel him. I want him to manifest himself. I want to feel after the things of God. Who is this? I'm almost done. So questions are going to happen. Who is this? Not only who is this, you can be seated. I got 6 minutes or so. Praise God. Musicians that can kind of get ready. I'm not done, but I'm landing. I'm landing this Boeing. Hopefully the door don't blow out. You'll get it later. Hallelujah. An escape hatch was meant to blow after you land, not before you land. Just so I'm hoping this blows after I land instead of I would say somebody say yes, but I don't want any prophetic voices going out right now. No. Praise not only causes people to ask, who is this? Praise will drive out sin and bring in prayer. Okay, well, you're going to have to help us with that. Okay. The Bible says that when they ask who he is, they say, this is Jesus of Nazareth. He goes in the temple and he drives out the money changers and those that sat in the seat selling doves. And he said, my house shall be called the house of prayer. You have made it a den of thieves. This is the second cleansing. This will let you know that every once in a while, what, know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost? Every once in a while, this good temple needs a cleansing. Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost? Just repent once and that's all right. No, that's not right. Every once in a while, when I begin to praise, God begins to show me places in my heart and in my mind and in my life that I can get things right. Hallelujah. Praise will drive out sin and bring in prayer. It will produce a temple cleansing. I'm telling you, I realize there's exceptions to the rule, but I'm telling you, when things get quiet and things get dry and things get dull, somebody said, well, why don't you just calm down a little bit? You get more folks if you calm down. I might get more of a crowd, but I wouldn't have much of a church. Crowds are going to dissipate. We learned that at the triumphal entry. They were all gone. He was there alone with Mary and Mary at the cross. But a church, the gates of hell can't prevail against the church. It's built on a rock and a sure foundation. Yes, Lord. Cleanses. That's why I want praise. I'm telling you, praise is the exposer of sin, and either people got to run out or get right. I want to get right. Praise says to God, you're bigger than me. You know more than me. I need you. I need deliverance. I need salvation. So, what is praise? I didn't have time to, let's all stand. I didn't have time to preach all this. I got a couple minutes left. Hallelujah. Someone said, why do you have people stand all the time? I want you to burn more calories. Hallelujah. Not really. I think it's good to honor. Regardless of your affiliation, whatever, when we have governors and assemblymen and presidents and people of honor, we stand to our feet. And I'm telling you, those jokers don't hold a candle to the one that's in this building right now. And I'm going to stand. Come on, I wish somebody had in their spirit. Do it, Jesus. Hallelujah. He can do more in 1 millisecond than someone can do in 4 years of office, or 2 years, or 6 years, or 8 years. I'm just going to call on him. I'm going to praise him. Cleanses. What does praise and prayer produce? Praise and prayer, now that is in the temple, will produce healing. The scripture says, when he got in the temple, and the blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he healed them. It's not just sick folk, although I believe the healing presence of God is here, but it's those that are, you're limping a little bit, been some trouble in your home. You're struggling a little bit. You're blind. You don't know which way to turn, where to go. And I want you to know that praise and prayer produces a place of healing. I believe the Lord can touch your emotions. I believe God can put together the divide that's in your home. I believe that God can clear arteries. I believe God can put sugar back where it needs to be. I believe God can take hearts and heal and mend. Prayer and praise will produce healing. It's the byproduct. You can't help but have it. Last but not least, verses 15 and 16. Here's the thing that ought to really just set you on fire. The self-righteous and the religious hate praise. Well, put it in language for me today. I'm just going to tell you, no one here ever graduates from praise. There's no retirement plan for your praise. Come on. I believe you're able to do this. I believe you're able to do this. I believe you're able to use this. Yes, Lord. Your way, Lord. I praise you, Lord. They hated him. They hated him. They looked to kill him, because the people were praising. Verses 15 and 16 of chapter 21. This is what happens. Let me just say this. Jesus goes on to tell a parable about the people that won't give praise. This parable is an incredible parable in the fact that you have the master of the house that sends servants to speak to those that are working in the field, and they kill the master's servants. And so then he sends more servants, and then they kill them, and then he sends his son, and they kill him. And then the master comes. What was he speaking? He was speaking to a generation that would not praise him. And every time that Jesus, the Lord, sent messengers, wouldn't hear. So he sent more messengers. How many preachers have to come by here? How many evangelists? How many sermons you have to hear? We can find flaws in everybody. It's easiest to kill me of anybody. Jesus just keeps sending them. Till finally, the Lord himself comes, robed in flesh at Bethlehem. And guess what? They slew him too. Hallelujah. The Lord's coming. My sin crucifies Christ, the scripture says. That's why I've got to get it right. I don't want any part in that. I know he died for me. But I don't want him crucified again because of me. So therefore, I'm going to find my place of prayer. I'm going to find my place to get it right. On this Sunday morning, I'm going to lift my voice. And I'm going to say, come on, deliver. Hosanna. Yes. You can walk into my temple. Hey, amen. You can cast anything out you want to cast out. Come on, come on. They're all coming. Come on, come on. Grab your family by the hand. Come on, we're worshiping the Lord right now. He's doing the work. Yeah.
Every praise is to our God.
Oh,
every word of worship.
Come on.
In one accord.
Wave your hands a little bit.
Every praise.
early this morning. The Lord woke me up about 4 a.m. this morning. Amen. He let me know it would please me to heal someone. And I don't know if it's physical or emotional. I think you need to pray. I just feel like God's in the granting business this morning. There's something about the spirit that I'm feeling that God wants to do something big for you. Why don't you turn to somebody, tell them what your need is, and then let's pray together that God would do the work. Come on, come on, come on, pray for somebody.
Oh God, my Savior. God my healer.
Come on, minister to somebody. Your neighbor, I want you to repeat after me. Ready? Look at somebody. Ready? Here it is. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Hey, this church is together this year. You can't stop my praise. I got my brother, my son. God, I feel the Holy. I got my brother and my sister right next to me. We're going to magnify the Lord. Woo! Come on, I felt something break just a little bit right there for somebody. Come on, encourage somebody in Jesus' name. Every praise.